because nobody is immune to fear. So are you going to let fear take your life? The devil comes and installs fear in your life, so you stay worried, you stay anxious, you stay afraid. And if you think about it, there is always going to be something in life that you are fearful of, something you can be worried about. But guess what? You better fight, and you better push on purpose. You need to, as you push on purpose and things are happening, you better talk to the devil. You gotta let him know you will not be defeated, that you will fight. You better tell him that he's under your feet.
Amen.
That he's behind you.
Yep.
Don't let him get in your ear. Don't let him get in your space.
Mm-hmm.
I can't understand why you would do that. I understand it may be challenging, but guess what? Y'all need to understand you are not by yourself. Okay? So you better let the devil know that your God is bigger than anything that he can try to do to you. You better fight. You better fight and push on purpose. I don't know about y'all, but I'm going to tell y'all something about me. When it's time for me to fight, and it's time for me to get down and dirty, and I'm ready, because I'm here to fight, and I'm not about to put up with that. That's right. I'm ready to fight. I'm ready to box up. I'm ready to walk the dog on the devil and let him know that I am not about to go down at all. I'm going to win my fight.
Amen.
And when I go to fight, like I said, I find God. And one of the best Psalms, and I just have to read a little bit of this further, okay? It says, it's Psalm 27. That's my favorite.
Yes.
Psalm 27.
Yes.
Y'all ought to know about that.
Yes.
It says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? Who shall I fear? Why are you fearful? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Who shall I be afraid? Why are y'all afraid? Why are y'all not fighting? Y'all got the right person to fight with. Y'all got it. But y'all choose to sit up and live in fear and stay afraid. We need to know that we need to continue to fight and push on purpose. Now, it also says, when the wicked advance against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. So as people come in your life, these enemies and these powers and principalities that we're fighting against, y'all just heard that. What are they going to do? Stumble and fall. See, but let me tell y'all why many of y'all have a problem. That's because y'all got the wrong people on y'all team. The wrong people on your team. You trusted in the wrong things. Okay? The wrong people. How dare you trust in money instead of God?
Right.
How dare you trust in your little job instead of God? You think that little job going to do something for you?
No.
It can't do nothing for you compared to what God can do for you.
All right.
How dare you trust in a degree when I got a degree?
Right.
I'm educated.
Yeah.
And what? Your education ain't going to help you when it's time that you really, really need to fight because you got a degree. So what? God is the creator of all those things I just talked about.
That's
the
right.
Money, that degree, your job, and everything else.
That's
so that's who you need when it's time to fight. your son sarcastic and full of excuses. It's just the truth. You don't want to fight. You don't want to push on purpose. You want everybody to feel sorry for you. Aww. I'm so sorry to have you. And if you want to wallow in that, that's not going to take you anywhere. That's not going to help you to get to the next level. That's not going to fix your life. You have got to push on purpose. You better fight. Okay. Yep, your baby daddy cheated. Okay. And you gave everything to him and didn't get anything from him. So your feelings are hurt. And now you want to stop your life. And like I said, stay stuck, stale, and stagnant. But you need to fight and push on purpose. Okay, you were passed over by the job. You gave them all these extra hours and you worked real hard. And they promised you the promotion and the new lady that came in. But you trained. Y'all know about that. She got that job, didn't she? So now you mad. You don't like them. You want to talk about them and complain all day. Instead of getting up and doing something and pushing on purpose, you sitting there complaining. You're not doing nothing for yourself. It's time to make a change. Please understand that your mess needs to be turned into a message. And you need to push on purpose. I've had some failures in my life. Maybe if y'all know my story. I have a school, Dream Big Preschool. Yes, I went through 6 times. I told the story many, many times. 6 times, 6 buildings fell through. But I didn't quit. I pushed on purpose. I sure did. And that seventh time, it happened. And I have a building. I got the building. And I have a child care facility. Yes, nationally and internationally accredited. Because I pushed on purpose. Because I decided to fight and not sit down when the devil was trying to keep me down. I said no. I was ready to fight. Bring it on. Yeah, I'm going to lie here and say I didn't cry and I didn't have some hard times. I did. I was upset. It wasn't easy. But I decided to push on purpose because God instilled in me a promise that I knew it would happen. God does not tell a lie. He will do what he said he's going to do. And as long as I know that, why wouldn't I push? Tell me that. Why wouldn't I push on purpose? Why wouldn't I fight when I have the greatest fighter right next to me? Now, I'm going to tell y'all something real quick and then I'm going to sit down. Y'all need to, like I said, stop walking around here weak, wimpy, defeated, looking all torn out and sad because something happened to you and things didn't go right in your life. You need to stop it. Before I had school, as you know, I was a science teacher. And tonight I want to bring out some things about science. I want to give a hypothesis. Y'all know what that is. That's an educated guess. And every time I stand up and talk, I like to give definitions. That educated guess is based upon prior knowledge and observation. I want to also make some predictions here tonight. And prediction is a statement about your future, which can be based on facts and evidence. I want to talk about patterns. That's consistent characteristics that happen that you've seen. And it just follows and follows. That's a pattern. Now, when you think about it, as you have had challenges in life, you got past them, right? And everything is all right. What you thought was going to break you down and kill you, something that really happened in your life that was bad, did you make it?
Amen.
Amen. Did you make it?
Yes.
Obviously, you did. You're here today. Life didn't stop. It continued. And predictions, that it shall be all right.
Okay,
it shall be all right. Based upon what you've been through, you saw what God can do for you. And as long as you have God, it's going to work out for you.
Yeah.
You just need to stay confident. You need to be courageous. And you need to just, let me tell you, when we're talking about confidence, let's bring it up in 2016. You need to get your pretty girl swag on.
What?
Okay? Pretty girl swag on. You may be sad. You may need your life fixed, but you need to get up and show up. Be beautiful. You better spend all that money to do that.
That's right.
Okay? You can go get you some 99-cent lipstick, put it on, do your own hair. But just look good. Get up, show up, and trust God. So with that, I want to tell you, stay confident, stay courageous, push on purpose, and fight for what you want. Looking all tired. It's a kind of long